Hey guys, it's Julian, and I'm wearing the mask because I want to support the movement where, you know, it's an ongoing movement with regards to mask wearing, and people say, you know, I protect you, you protect me. So I just want to encourage that. Today in this video, I want to talk about the best sleeping position for wealth, success, and also like more happiness. Okay, so the reason I wanted to make this video today. I wanted to share some findings, okay, and as you guys listen to this video, I want you guys to take some notes and let me know, or if you haven't already checked, whip out your phone compass right now and check where is the position of your head facing when you sleep, and type that in the comments below. Okay, so do me this favor right now. Use a compass, or if you have a different phone or something, you know the directions well, let me know where is your head facing when you sleep, okay? And comment below in the video. So it's kind of bizarre. As you guys know, I posted on my Facebook during the last week or so that I was trying to recreate the conditions where I found my first success, made my first million online, and in order to do that, I was sleeping on the sofa. Actually, there was another reason why I was sleeping on the sofa was because I had an argument with my wife and we just didn't see eye to eye on some things, and I decided, okay, I'm just going to sleep on the couch. But apart from that, okay, I was trying to, when I recreated the feelings, you know, it was interesting, I felt every day I was waking up refreshed, I felt motivated, and I didn't need as many hours of sleep as I used to. Never mind that my wife's bloody chihuahuas were you know, having a fight from time to time, which disturbed my sleep, but yet I felt fresh with less hours of sleep than when I had more hours of sleep. And this is really interesting. So once again, for those of you who came into this video, I want you to do me this favor and comment in the comments below, where does your head face when you sleep? Now, a couple of things that I want to share with you guys, but for those of you who just came on, please wear your face mask. I want to support this movement where they say, you know, I protect you, you protect me. Wear a face mask because, like, the, you know, researchers have proven that even a cloth mask can actually catch about 95% of the particles when you respire and speak. So coming back to this sleeping position, pay special attention to those where the head sleeping position is in the north. This is known to be the worst possible sleeping position, and at the same time, for those with the head sleeping position in the west, okay, this is also another very bad sleeping position. So if you are unable to check your sleeping direction because you're not home right now, or can't remember where it faces, or because you're watching this video and you're unable to use the compass in your phone, then I would love for you to check that when you are able to do so today, and come back to this video and tell me where your head is currently facing when you sleep. Now, I used to think that, well, maybe I just slept better on the couch, maybe that was the reason why, but there's more to that. What I found out is that sleeping with your head facing the north is the worst. It's worse not only for feng shui, it is worse based on Indian Vastu beliefs. It is worse even based on science. Even based on science, and that's, you know, really, really interesting, right? So how is that even possible that it's based on science? Well, let me show you a little illustration. I have with me an aircon control, okay? And when I flick open the back cover, you notice that the battery is one up and one down. And why is that? Have you ever wondered why? Of course, it's a North Pole and South Pole thing. If, you know, from time to time, let's say if we are not using a piece of electronics for a long period of time, there are some people out there, what they do is that they flip the batteries around, because when you flip the batteries around, it's a broken connection. Now, some of you in my Facebook, in fact, many of you on my Facebook, for those of you who are not my personal friends, you are friends of me on Facebook probably because you like the things that I do, and you just want to keep up with, you know, the ways I think, the activities that I do, my, you know, my my business opportunities, my business experiments, and blah blah blah. And I want you to just have a think about it, because think about why is it okay, if you're along those lines, generally you know that, I mean, I have the people who still follow me after years, you do so because you like my beliefs, okay? And one of the things I believe in a lot is the law of attraction. I believe in the power of the universe, okay? And I think a couple of you do, like Ezan, Joyce, Joshua, Nicholas. I know you guys, Nico. I know you guys are into these things because you believe that, like attracts like. Intentions have power. And something very interesting about this, hey there, Paul, is that because we believe that there's a resonation, there's earth energy, there's universal energy. Did you know the optimal position when the head is sleeping in the south position, that is the best, because you're actually able to have the earth recharge you as you sleep. Now, isn't that interesting? It's kind of like this, because when you're in a north-south direction, okay, when it's in opposite directions, when so that, imagine one is earth, one is you, we have a flow of energy. But if you are hit in the north, the and hit in the north, and so and that's like north versus north, two magnets, what happens? It repels. Isn't that interesting? It repels. And if you have like the batteries pointed the same way, this little device is not gonna work. Think about that. So let me tell you my experience of the last 2 years. What exactly happened in the last 2 years? Okay. No doubt you've seen that I have gone from a small apartment in Singapore over the past few years, a pa small apartment in Singapore, to a rented house that was bigger. And then after a short time in that rented house, I moved to here because I like the estate and all that. But the irony of the situation is when I moved to this house that I live in, my overall business went down. Okay? Isn't that interesting? Went down. Not only that, like my wife and I had increased amount of argument, increased amount of conflict. We would bicker and fight over the most trivial things. And on top of that, me and my wife, we were constantly fatigued. We slept more than we used to, and yet we felt so fatigued. And we just were not enthusiastic for day-to-day life. And I found out that we, no wonder, based on what I know now, no wonder, because it's kind of like if, these batteries are both pointed the same way, the circuit is not complete. And we were having our head in the north position, exact north. Okay, exact north, like out this way is exact north. Like what you see right here is exact north. I know my room is like in a mess, right? This is like my storeroom, but now I'm gradually converting it into my in my work area. I'm gonna put in like partitions and all that, and I'm gonna put some nice painting in the background here. Right now, I'll show you like I have momentarily used my DJ table as as my work table. And right now, this is actually a boss's position, okay? I know this is not sounding so scientific. This is a little bit more in the feng shui and vastu kind of way. So, and I know some of you are experts in this area, and you probably can spot a couple of flaws like sharp edges and stuff. I'll be getting around that, over the next couple of over the next couple of days. But what's currently here? Okay, I tell you. Like right now, the way it's configured, I have my table faced in a north northeast direction, okay? Because this is absolute north. This is now northeast. And in over here, there's actually my wife's merchandise that she has manufactured, like some beauty electronic devices. I've actually put them in this corner because if the the merchandise is in the northwest vicinity of the of the, of you know of a storage, it will sell better. Okay, and then at this point of time, I also am seated right now in the south. I'm in the southwest of this room. Okay, and the door that is coming over here is at an angle. Okay, so it's like there's no concerns of anyone sneaking up whatsoever. So I mean, like, I have after I found out that the past 2 years I have been sabotaging myself in my life, deeply sabotaging my health, and it's interesting. Maybe it also had to do with it that like I mentioned, when you sleep in a in the, when you hit in the south, the earth resonates with you and recharges you as you sleep. And maybe that also played a part in my weight loss, which was phenomenal over the past, although I didn't do anything different. And okay, now interesting things would also be that now my kids had always had disturbed sleep and frequent nightmares. Their head was constantly facing in the west. Okay, so in the previous in previously in Singapore, they had disturbed sleep. Currently, they complain to me that they have frequent nightmares. And the previous house that we lived in, the rented house, they were sleeping with the head in a northeast direction, which is apparently not good and not bad. Okay, but so it was better. So, and they told me also that they slept better there. I told them this without actually confirming, without actually explaining to them what this meant. And so today I've also shifted my kids' sleeping position. And last night I actually decided to use this hypothesis to test it out. What if I have my head? I go to my usual room. I used to think that maybe it's the bed being too soft. That's why I never felt good. But strangely enough, I had my head in the south for the first time last night. And I woke up thinking that I missed my alarm. But in actual fact, I slept at 3. I woke up at, before 8. I felt totally refreshed. I felt totally motivated for today. And it was, and because I, after all, hey, the bed, it was more expensive than the couch. And it was a better sleep. And I was amazed. So I realized, I mean, this may sound to some extent, it's not too, for those of you who follow me in trading, I like to do a lot of statistics, a lot. I like to do a lot of endurance tests, A/B testing, all that. But I mean, this may just be one day of A/B test, but I'm going to continue doing that, and I'm going to keep updating you how that is. In the meantime, like after this video, I would love for you to, check what is the current head sleeping position, and comment beneath this video. Come back and comment beneath this video, and if your head is currently in the north or in the west when you sleep tonight, try having your head in the south and let me know how you feel tomorrow. Okay, that's what I really would love to do, and I just wanted to share something that works because like it was definitely no coincidence that during the time where I made my first 2 million, I was sleeping with my head in the south position, and for the last 2 weeks, my business had suddenly made, tremendous growth on various aspects, and it's definitely too much of a coincidence with the things that I found out today, where not only is it proven in science, but it is actually what the Indian Vastu followers believe in, what the feng shui people believe in, and from a scientific point of view, like I mentioned, because of the magnetism of the north, it actually causes the imbalance of metal concentration, the iron, okay, which in depression, people take take pills that have metal minerals in it. Apparently, it's to resolve the neurochemistry. But you know, when I read that the neurochemistry can actually be disrupted when we have our head in a north position, I was like, whoa, this is more than feng shui. This is more than vastu. So guys, please you know, check your head sleeping position. Comment beneath this video and let me know. I would love to hear your responses. And tonight, if you're currently sleeping in the west position or in the north position, change it to the south. And if you have kids, look into having their head sleeping position in the east and let me know how that works out for you. I would love to know, and I hope this helps you out. It is a biohack. Okay, this is a biohack, it's a life hack. And just want to share something good to you. Bye for now.